we're live at the Mobile World West Africa event, and we'll be talking with Jason Njoku, who is the CEO of Iroko Partners. Yeah, you heard right. That's the rock star behind the platform that is about digitizing all of Nigeria's entertainment. And we're going to be talking with him about pretty much about his presentation today, which was mind-blowing. Personally, I think that you stole the show. Something that you mentioned about how you guys started, or how you started, and which big time, and it's different, from what we would find entrepreneurs back home actually starting companies. So for you, you pick an interest in Hollywood, the industry, and then that was it. What would you say was that driving factor? Maybe you can address another
one and
starting
from
the industry
that
might be
not. So if you look at Hollywood, it's 50% to film, 50% to marketing. So that's 50% marketing, 50% to film. Hollywood is like this magical thing where there's no marketing. It'd be very hard for us to find a company that has not heard of it. Whether they've watched the movie or not, irrelevant, but they've heard of it. Something that
happened.
There must have been sort of many different ways of making money. At the moment, 96% of actual revenue in China is making DVD sales. We were just like, well, that makes no sense because there are so many different channels to make money from. Right. We just look at the internet. Like, we're actually not an internet company. We're looking at all the sort of channels to make money from. If there's a single place, it's the most obvious one.
Now, talking about different platforms, you recently launched something on mobile, various platforms on mobile. Iroko is a music application that lets you stream Nigerian music. Maybe African music. What time?
Nigerian music.
Strictly Nigerian music. Okay.
The last thing is about focus. I think if you see Nigerian music, I don't have to tell you a range of artists. You probably know them already.
Right.
So why do the hard work of saying Africa? If I told you Africa, you won't know what I'm talking about. If you're Nigerian, you know what I'm talking about. And that goes for like people in Nigeria and people in the diaspora. So it's really simple. The marketing is the best example. Just for your communication to everybody,
yeah.
We're focused on Nigeria content. It's good enough, and there's a lot of it for us to kind of be able to figure out. So I think Nigerian content is the best. So it's popular. We're just facilitating the artists, the musicians, movie stars, the production artists, and their fans. We just sit in the middle and just make people. That's all. And we just figure out ways to make money.
So let's talk about Iroko TV. And you guys seem to be pushing that a lot more than Iroko TV. So of course that's probably the reason for that. But my question is, you said last year that you may have to charge users to actually stream movies at a particular point in time.
You will charge. Right. Not me. We will charge.
Right.
I think there's a few things about that. One is that this stuff is not cheap. Like, the cost of buying a movie is about $1,000 over the last 18 months. It's important that for us to bring the best man newest movies, they're more expensive than the one which we made in 2008. So when we first started, we bought all these movies which they weren't even selling in the marketplace. Oh, have you got this movie in 2004, 5, 6, 7? They're like, sure, it's in my cupboard somewhere. I said, hey, let me give you some money. It was really easy stuff. As we moved our base of movies, we basically ran out of buying the old stuff. We had to start buying the new stuff, and the new stuff was expensive. And fans, they want the new stuff, the brand new stuff. So we want to pay for this stuff, and good, like some of the brand new movies.
Premium ones, yeah?
I would say just brand new.
Okay.
Because,
okay.
We buy some movies. We buy premium. We buy like an image, I buy like something else. It's not really a fine brand. It's more like brand new movies. So, other than the presentation, the brand new movies, we get them first.
Right.
And you're not going to get them anywhere else. You don't get them on the market. You don't get them. It's a Facebook thing, which is like a big box of it.
Yeah.
But it's not in the market. You can't actually get it anywhere other than our website. We have the game. We do a good job. So it's, again, connecting them with the most best movies and fast and time possible. And for the producers, really easy. They come to us, write them a check. It's pure profit. It's not like they're like printing DVDs and doing something. They literally come, give us the hard drive, we take the movie, we write them a check, pay nobody. And it's just a way for them to pay for their movie making, or even to become really important part of that ecosystem.
There's something interesting about your presentation as well, that someone asked the question about, okay, there's a CC Hub, the great guys doing some social entrepreneurship stuff there. And the question was, would there be a situation where your partners would get to involve those guys and maybe it will be part of your group? And your answer was, your hope is really easy. If you hire, you hire over 80 people that would implement. My question is, do you see something else coming out of, say, foundation or some philanthropic aspect to what you're doing? Because generally people could view your work as maybe some capitalist in some sort. You said it, but would there be a time when we would have some sort of support in, like, an accelerator or something to help, for me,
Nigeria has a problem.
Yeah.
They are churning out hundreds of thousands of veterans.
Yeah.
No jobs.
Yeah.
This country does not need social innovation. It needs jobs.
Right.
The biggest impact you can have on someone's life is to give them a well-paying job, which they enjoy, and then they've got support and they've got a career going forward in the country. That is the most important thing. Me, it's, well, I can bang the drum of sort of social entrepreneurship. We can sit down here, we can have tools and discuss things, or I can pay you a very good wage with very good benefits to work in a very great environment, with the idea that the experience you gain with me is just about pure capitalism. And I tell all of my top guys, I've said this again, my kids have told this for a time, if you ever go back to Cuba, I'll never speak to you again. If you get away from me, I'll never talk to you again. If you came to me an idea in 2 weeks' time, and you said, I want to go and do this idea, because I know you, I'm the first person to write the check. Go through and be successful as well. Because for me, any of my top guys, if they're working for me, like 3 to 5 years' time, they would have failed. And for me, that's the ecosystem that you need. It doesn't need social entrepreneurship. It needs like 100 of them.
Great jobs. And that's pretty much what Steve Jobs did.
Yeah. Absolutely. But yeah, if you look at Silicon Valley, look at the world creation in the US, on the internet. Look at the world creation in the UK. Look at the world creation in Europe. Look at the world creation in Asia, in India, in Australia, in the Arab world, in Africa. NGO mentality, they look fucked. If you don't build this company for so long, then this country doesn't have much of a problem. For me, it's really important that we have this team staying invested, have people willing to write a check and really help push the idea forward to the point where it starts making a return on investment, seeing it then. Money was definitely not worth it. Someone made a new year, they made some money, people rushed in. More people rushed in, more money was made, more people rushed in. Why not most young girls when they're in the most young people in the mission? What? It's successful. What was it about? 5 years ago, the man was to his family, his friends, and about this is a joke. Now there are like $100,000. And that has built up the industry. And I think the tech scene definitely has it. The internet is so many problems to solve here in Virginia.
Absolutely. I do believe that I will. Thanks so much for your time.